What's up, peers, and welcome to the World Crypto Network with a reading of ZeroLink, the Bitcoin Fungibility Framework. Chapter 2, Part 3, Sybil Attacks. It is possible to de-anonymize a user if every participant of the mix is an attacker, except the user. Similarity to Jim Sybil attack mixing for Bitcoin, the cost of this attack grows as the anonymity set grows. However, unlike in XIM, this attack is only feasible if the tumbler is the attacker. If the attacker is not the tumbler, it would have to figure out exactly in which round the targeted user participated in, and it must make sure nobody else gets to participate in that mix. Furthermore, executing a covert Sybil attack as the tumbler is not evident depends on the protocol implementation. Overt Sybil attacks as a tumbler is always possible, however, in the case the tumbler is accountable. To execute this attack, when the tumbler notices an input is registered that it wants to de-anonymize, it must refuse all the following input registrations and all the connection confirmations that have already been registered and that are not from the target. Refusing input registration can happen for many reasons, therefore it can be done in a covert way. However, refusing connection confirmations cannot. It can only happen if the inputs has been spent. Therefore, malicious tumbler can be noticed. Clients whose connection confirmations are refused and they did not prematurely spend their inputs should not use that tumbler anymore. The cost of the Sybil attack at $1 transaction fee is 1.2 times the number of Sybils times 1. If the number of Sybils is 100, then the denomination is 1 Bitcoin. The tumbler must first pre-divide 100 Bitcoin into 101 Bitcoin outputs, which is about $1 times 100 times 0.2 equals $20. Wait until the transaction confirms, and then it must pay the CoinJoin fee, which is about $100. So the cost of the attack is roughly $120 per round. This pattern can be noticed by the PostMix wallet, and in this case, the PostMix wallet may require remixing the coins. There are various other ways to address Tumbler Sybil attacks in expense of the complexity of the premix wallet implementation. Defending Sybil attacks should be an interest of future research. Pierce, thank you very much for joining me here in the reading of the ZeroLink Fungibility Framework, Chapter 2, Part E, on Sybil attacks. And as usual, thank you very much for joining me and see you. Bye-bye.